Hey, what's up guys? Archer here, and I have a probably short video today on Rust. I'm not going to be playing Rust again. It's basically just going to be me telling you all this stuff and whatnot, but the reason why I haven't been playing Rust for the past couple of videos is because I came to an idea on what I could tell you guys. And basically what my main thought was, I can't really process everything I want to tell you while I'm playing the game, you know, because I do play on public servers, and it's not like I have all the time in the world to do something. And when I try to play on a server, I have to intently gather all the supplies I need to show you guys. And this can even take 3, 4, maybe upwards of a week to even get situated on a server and to get what I want to show you guys, what I want to show you without, like, you know, investing like 5 hours in one day, because I know I'm not going to do that. So I thought that this would be the better alternative to just basically write out what I need to tell you guys and go in depth from there. So the video that I'm going to be showing you guys today is the basically proper placements of wood gates and spike walls and how you can effectively protect your base or deter possible people from raiding you. So first things first, the wood gate and the wood gateway are two separate items. They don't come together. And the gateway is the, I guess you could say, foothold of basically everything you need. And the wood gate is the actual wooden parts that go into the wood gateway. Now, you need 120 wood to build the wood gate, and need 400 wood for the wood gateway. And both of these items take 2 days to despawn. And by 2 days to despawn, you can literally not open it for 2 days, and we'll say not open it for a day, and it'll still be there. Surely it'll be decayed, so all you really need to do is just put some logs in your hotbar and press the correct number that the logs are in, and it'll should take up some logs, but it'll repair it as if it's brand new. And it takes quite a while to take down with a pickaxe. Just take my word for it on that one. And spike wall, these are the smaller ones. And they're not that effective unless it's right against the wall. So what I would do is place the small spike walls against the wall and the large spike walls right in front of the small spike walls, because you can easily jump over the you can easily jump over the small spike walls, and that's honestly a waste unless you say have some leftover wood and just want to I don't know, put some small spike walls down somewhere. And the small spike wall takes 3 days to despawn, and it takes 100 wood. And every time you melee hit it with a pickaxe or with an axe or anything for that matter, you will take damage, and there's a good chance that you will bleed. So you're going to want bandages, small med kit, or a large med kit. My personal preference is a honestly, it's probably just a large med kit, because while you're taking damage, it'll still regenerate, because it regenerates 100 health. And the next is a large spike wall, and that takes 200 wood, and it's about 10 to 20 damage each time you touch it. Well, so when you hit it with a pickaxe or anything like that, it's about 10 to 20 damage. And this takes 2 days to despawn. Now, that's basically all I have to show you guys for today. I probably won't have many pictures because I couldn't really get in game to get the specific items that I want to show you, but sorry about that, basically. As for the subscriber, I did have a server that I planned on showing you guys, but I decided against it, and I'm still looking for servers to play on permanently, and I'm looking for a teamspeak to speak on as well, if possible, or a mumble, or ventrilo, anything like that, if you guys want to participate. And if you have that, go ahead and post in the comments below, and we can see what we can plan up. And other than that, that's basically it. So this has been the wood gate and spike wall tutorial on how to effectively use those. And I guess I didn't really go over how to effectively use them. If you want to effectively use them, honestly, it's personal preference. There is no correct way to use them. If you wanted to say put like a layer of large spike wall and small spike wall, that's honestly fine. But if anything, you do not want to have only small spike walls unless it's against a physical wall, because you can easily jump over spike walls. But large spike walls, those are a major deterrent, and spike walls in general tell the person who's going to raid you that, well, maybe this won't be so easy after all. So always keep that in mind, and remember, if your base isn't found at all, then you have that much of a lower chance to get raided. So that's basically it. Thank you guys so much for listening. I am Archer, and I am signing out.